Greetings and yeah, it's nice to be with you again. We'll start with an activity, please, right? Please raise both your hands. You can be seated. Please raise your hands. Make a fist and bring them in front of your chest. Just do as I do. Right arm forwards. Right arm backwards. Left arm forwards. Left arm backwards. Both arm forwards, both arm backwards. Everyone able to do that? Easy? Now comes the catch, right? Right arm forward, left arm backward. Right arm forward, left arm backward. See whether it is possible for you to do that. I am able to see a few people who are able to do that, but try persisting. Right arm forward, left arm backward. Okay, raise your right hand alone and draw clockwise circles, right? Clockwise circles, right? What you are doing is anti-clockwise, right? You need to clockwise, right? Yeah, clockwise circles. Everyone able to do that? Yeah, please put down your hands using the big toe of your right leg. Big toe of your right leg. Try putting number 9, numeral 9. Able to do that? Yes or no? Yes. Now try doing both. Clockwise circles and number 9. What happens? What happens? A few of you might be able to do that, but most of you may not be able to do that. So, dear friends, what's the reason for this? Why this is easy, this is easy, this is not so easy. Why is it? Why is that? Even early time, fresh time in the morning, it becomes impossible for someone. And it might be really impossible. What time? What place? Even on a different planet, it could be really impossible for you to put clockwise circles in the number 9 in the normal way which you do that. Any idea? Most probably we'll be thinking it is as a problem with the mind. We are not able to do two things at the same time. It might be your perception, but it's not so, dear friends. The real reason is how our brain is. It's a physiological process of how our brain is. We do have a brain. Yes or no? Yes. Maybe our mathematics teachers doubted that. And I'm sure after marriage, your spouse will doubt that. Right? But we do have a brain. And the dear friends, the brain is in two halves. One is the left brain, the other is the right brain. So the left brain controls the right limbs of the body. So when you move your right hand forward, the command should come from the left brain. When you move your left hand forward, the command should come from the right brain. When you move both the hands forward, both the brains give the same command, forward. When you move both the hands backward, both the brains give the same command, backward. So it's easy for you. Both hands forward, both hands backward. But when you do this, right arm forward, left arm backward, the left brain should give you a forward command, the right brain should give you a backward command. Try it once again with this idea. See whether you are able to do that, right? Consciously do that. Right arm forward, left arm backward. Yes, a few of you might be able to get that idea. Now the sync happens. What happens is now you are able to realize that the brain is in two halves. The purpose of these activities is to make us understand. Because I can't call a person here to stand, break open his skull and show you the brain is in two halves. That could not be done. So we are trying to understand that by inference, and that's why the purpose of these activities in decision making, which brain is useful? That's the question. Yes. So left brain stands for logic, logical analysis. Analytical thinking, left brain stands for that. Language, when you speak language, it comes from your left brain powerfully. The broadcast part takes care of it. When you go into the details of anything, it is the left brain that is doing the functioning. And when you differentiate one thing from the other, it is your left brain. On the other hand, the right brain is so fantastic and in contrast. When you listen to music, it is your right brain that is being activated. When you draw something, when you paint something, it is your right brain that is being activated. And when the left brain handles language as a communication tool, right brain handles what? When the left brain handles verbal communication, the right brain handles non-verbal communication. Your ability to emote, your ability to connect with people, your ability to have forceful, powerful relationship, everything comes from the right brain. When the left brain is for details, right brain is for the whole picture, trying to understand the wholeness of life, that's the right brain. And when the left brain differentiates, the right brain tells you, you need to integrate. And in fact, for decision making process, we need to have the use of both the brains, because any one brain, if you use in a decision making process, it could lead you to difficult situations. When you too much rely only on logic for decision making purposes, you might be successful but may not be happy. But when you use only your right brain for decision making purposes, you end up as a very happy person, but you may not be successful in life, because left brain gives you success, right brain gives you happiness. And as a society of a whole, if you consider, you will be able to find out that the dominant portion of the brain is the left brain. Society is dominantly left brain oriented. 100 years before, 150 years before, what was the type of brain domination of the society? What is that you think? 100 years before, how was the society predominantly? It was right brain dominated. Now the society is predominantly left brain dominated. When a child, when it is born and as it ages up, it is right brain dominated. From when does it become a left brain dominated child? Any ideas? When one day when you wake it up early, give it a force bath, put on something which is called as a uniform and drag it. Kadara kadara eduthittu porom. We drag it to a place which is called a school. From that day, the orientation starts shifting from the right to the left. All the school curriculum is taught only to the left faculties, logic, analysis, language, details, differentiation. So whatever is taught in the college curriculum, school curriculum caters only to the left, and it becomes an imperative of the society, of the elders, of the family members to teach the right brain aspect to the child. So leftist stands for IQ, right stands for EQ. Left is intelligent quotient based, right is emotional quotient based. Left is for success, right is for happiness. So the main important thing is, when you make a decision, from which part of the brain you come from? That's a very important question which you need to understand. I'll tell you two important stories, two anecdotes to understand this. You would have heard of that war of Troy. Troy was seized by Greeks, maybe for 10 months it is said. 10 months the Greeks were surrounding the fort of Troy and they were having a siege over it. But Troy could not be defeated. And then there was one guy, one very intelligent guy by the name Ulysses, who was there in the Greek, and he constructed a war horse, a wooden horse. It was a big wooden horse. He kept some soldiers inside that, and then the Greeks mounted a fake withdrawal. It was a drama. They simply gave an enactment of moving out, and the Troy of people were really happy. We were able to withstand the siege, therefore we have won. So they opened their gates and out came the king of Troy. His name was Priam. He came over, and there on the seashore he found a very big wooden horse, and the people around Priam tell that it was a token. It was a token of gift. It was a token representing the surrender of the Greeks, so we should take it inside. Some of the people said, anyhow it belongs to the aliens, enemies, we should not take it inside. So that was a deciding moment for Priam. Everything depended on his decision. In those days, the king was ultimate decider. So what happened is, when Priam was trying to analyze that, he came powerfully from the emotional right brain. 10 months of Caesar were able to overcome that. So from the joy, from the happiness, from that exalted spirit, he felt that we need to have the token, let's take the horse inside. And once the horse was taken inside at the midnight, the soldiers, hidden Greek and Greek